Hi, my name's David from OM-1 and welcome to this quick tutorial on the OM-1's Starry Sky autofocusing feature. Today we're going to look at how to set and activate the Starry Sky autofocusing feature on the OM-1. This is a very powerful tool designed to help enhance your nightscape photography. Now, a couple of things to remember before we get started, and that is that the Starry Sky AF function is designed to work on tiny points of light that are very, very far away. Which means that if you're trying this out at home and you're not finding that the camera is working very well, or even trying to focus at all, then that's perfectly normal in a short distance, well lit environment. When it all goes dark, the camera will then try to focus from infinity towards you as quickly as it can. Now, there are a few other things to remember when we're talking about Starry Sky autofocusing function, but let's get into the menu first and start to set it up and understand things from there. So first of all, press the menu key on your OM-1 and navigate to the third tab across, which is the green AF tab. Using the cursor buttons around the OK button, you can navigate to the third option down for Starry Sky AF setting and press OK. In Starry Sky AF setting, we have only three options. The top option is to decide whether or not we will need speed or accuracy. If you're using your camera handheld, we recommend using the speed option, but if you're using a tripod, you can use the accuracy option as a little bit more processing time will be required until the focusing is completed. Pressing menu will take us back to hit our next option, which is AF operation, and this is all about which buttons will start the process. By default, this is set to AF starts on the AF on button, and you can also stop it by pressing the button again. You can also select AF starts with AF on, and you'd have to hold that button down to complete focusing. Or the lesser used option is maintaining AF on the front half press of the shutter button. The general recommendation would be for AF on start stop option. This means that you can use the AF on button on the back of the camera to let the camera focus on the stars and then release from the front shutter button without worrying about the refocusing occurring. And the final option in Starry Sky AF setting is the release priority. The release priority simply means will the camera be able to take an image if it's not in focus? If we're selected to on, then yes it will. The camera is able to take an out of focus image. Now of course we don't want that, so the majority of the time we'll leave the release priority set to off. This also means that the camera will not take an image at all if it can't grab focus, and you must release the AF button and press again to try to lock focus once more. So, as powerful a tool as Starry Sky AF is, those three very simple options are all you'll need to set up in order to get going with this. Now, of course, that's just setting the options. We need to activate the Starry Sky AF from our autofocusing options. You may have a button set up to choose between AF, but I'm going to go here from the Super Control Panel by pressing OK on my camera. So I've pressed OK on the camera and my Super Control Panel has popped up. Using those direction keys, I'm going to navigate to the AF mode option and press OK. And then right at the very end of this line of options here is the Starry Sky autofocusing setting. Pressing OK will lock that in for me and take me back to a live view. I can then use my AF on button to start the focusing process and allow the camera to grab focus and lock onto those stars. Now remember, that focus is locked to my AF on button, so once it's finished focusing, I can release my front shutter button whenever I like to complete the exposure. So just to round up those quick tips, remember that Starry Sky AF won't really work in a well-lit environment, and you can use your AF on button to lock focus and your front shutter release to take the photograph. I hope this tutorial has been useful. If you need any more information, check out our YouTube channel, subscribe for notifications when we put up new videos and go live. But I'll see you on another tutorial sometime in the future very soon. Thanks, and bye-bye for now.